Hi, you're watching BK Hobby, and today I'm excited to show you something I learned myself just a few days ago. If you haven't heard of it yet, HABpanel is a fairly new feature in openHAB. It's a touchpad-friendly user interface that allows you to set up functional screens and dashboards for your home automation equipment. It's much easier to use on touchpads than the standard basic UI. It also allows great flexibility and creativity in designing your user interface. And best of all, it's childishly simple to get started with, as I will show you in this video. So first, I want to give a shout out to David at smarthomeblog.net. It was after reading his terrific blog post that I decided to give HABpanel a shot. Until I read it, I definitely had a bit of a bias against HABpanel. I tried it briefly when it first came out and found the initial setup clunky and with a steep learning curve. David does a fantastic job explaining the basics of HABpanel, the first steps in setting it up, and even goes deeper into creating your own widgets to add to the UI. Definitely check out his blog. I will post a link to it in the description below. To get started with HABpanel, go to your openHAB server's paper UI, click on Add-ons, User Interfaces, and select Install by the HABpanel icon. Mine is already installed, but the setup shouldn't take long for you at all. Now you should see the HABpanel tile show up on your main openHAB screen. Click on it, and it will open a new HABpanel window. From here, you can start setting up your user interface. In my case, I've already started setting up my home automation layout, but when you first start, you're going to see a bare screen here. On this panel, you can create links that will take you to different dashboards you set up. Click on the settings icon, and click on Add Dashboard. Type in the name, and hit OK. And this will create your dashboard. You can set the number of columns here depending on how you want to lay out your dashboard. When you're done setting it up, hit the settings icon again, and this will take you back to your main screen. Dashboards can group your automation devices any way you want. You can create different dashboards per room, per floor of the house, per function, for example, lighting or AC. It's really up to you to organize your system in a layout that makes sense. Once you have a dashboard created, you can add widgets to it. Widgets are functional components that can perform an action, show a value, or even just label your dashboard. For example, when I click the edit button here, I can add some widgets. I'm going to add a dummy widget. Hit this icon here, click on edit, select an item, for example the outside temperature. I'll name it outside temperature and hit save. I can resize, move, and configure my widget any way I want without touching any code, and I think this is a killer feature for openHAB. Once I'm done setting it up, I'll hit save, run, and now I have the temperature outside shown in this widget. So let me show you what I was able to come up with in a few short hours. After spending a few evenings getting familiar with the interface and how widgets actually work, I came up with this dashboard layout to control my home. Here you can see my first floor dashboard, with labels showing each room and the widgets below linked to the items I'm able to control in that room. For example, the kitchen cabinet lights, which change colors when I click on the color widget, or change to a different effect when I select one from the effect menu. So my second floor dashboard is still empty, but I can copy the widgets I've created in the first floor dashboard to save me some time. So I'm going to click on edit again, and for the widgets I want to copy, I'll select copy move to, select the second floor dashboard, and hit copy. I'm going to do this for the other widgets that I want to copy, and now I'm going to click on second floor, and it's now showing the widgets I copied from the first floor. Now I just need to click on edit in my second floor dashboard and make the widgets I copied from the first floor dashboard match the items I have set up for my master bedroom devices. I'll fix the label first. Type in master bedroom, hit save. Next, I'll point the slider widget to my master bed lamp. And I'll point my temperature and humidity widgets to the master bedroom as well. These come from the sensors that I built in my previous videos. Now I'm going to move these items around to organize them a little bit better. Hit save and run. And my second floor dashboard comes to life. I can control the lamp and view the temperature and humidity within the master bedroom. So if you're using the HABpanel feature already or have other cool ideas for dashboards or widgets, leave me a comment below. And if you like what you see, subscribe for more videos on home automation. Until next time, this is BK Hobby. Thank you.